I mean, I can't even describe the sadness that I felt. I mean, and the crazy thing about being a comedian is that no matter what bad news you hear or what's going on tragic in the news, whether it's in Missouri or going on in Iraq or whatever happens, comedians still have to be funny.
They still have to be funny, right.
And so I'm doing my segment for the Tom Joyner Show, working at night to record for the next day, and it was so difficult because I could not shake the loss of Robin Williams. I mean, you talk about a guy who was such a bright, bright, bright light, who was such an overpowering presence in show business, just to think of the sadness that was behind that, you know, and how it must have been a struggle for him at the very end was very devastating. But never be another Robin Williams. Never, ever, ever be another Robin Williams.
I don't know. Everybody says comedians have a dark side. I don't know. I don't know if I'm running from it. I'm dark. That's the only dark side.
He's really dark. He's got a really, really dark side. It's called his ass. But you know what? I think it's unfair.
But you hear it all the time.
Right, but it's not just comedians. Everybody.
Everybody.
Everybody. There are people who, right. There are people who work in the military, people who work in your office, people who work in restaurants. Everybody. Yeah, a lot of people have sadness. Okay, yeah. A lot of people have sadness that they carry around.
Everybody's
wearing a backpack and they keep collecting. They collect more of the sad things that happen to them, and the happy things they let go. But they carry around all the things that hurt them in their lives, all the disappointments, you know, all the daily miseries. They carry it around, but most of you just don't know about it because most people just don't share.
The mask,
they don't share that weight on people. Now, we all have a friend who doesn't mind unloading all their crap every single day and crying on the phone. But for the most part, people just...
Some of them are relatives. Most of them are relatives.
People are functioning sad on a daily basis in this country. Around the world, they function sad.
Right.
So not just comedians. I think it's just overblown because we're supposed to be funny.
People think we're supposed to be turned up all the time.
Right.
Supposed to be funny all the time.
It's the first time you did that.
Really?
Yeah.
Did I do it right?
Yeah, you did that. Outside of the strip club. Tweak them. But I tell you this, Huggy and I have talked about, and we both have things in our lives, whether it's family or deaths we've dealt with and stuff like that, and they cause sadness, but we've never ever allowed show business to be a source of sadness because we understand that every single day that we're allowed to do what we do, we're extremely blessed.
And
show business, like from a man's perspective, show business is like a woman.
Uh-oh.
Right this way.
Do tell, Chris.
But this woman is beautiful. She's sexy. She's voluptuous. But she doesn't owe you anything, you know?
No injection.
It's all natural.
Okay.
But she doesn't owe you anything. So if you see her with this other dude, like let's say you see her with somebody more successful than us. Let's say if you see her over kissing
Dave
Chappelle.
That's a lot of people too.
Right. You see her over kissing Dave Chappelle, you can't get mad. You see her over there with Martin Lawrence, and you can't get mad. You know, they've got her right now. You know, so she doesn't owe you anything. So you be good.
He can't get mad.
You be good to your woman. You appreciate her while you have her.
I'm mad as hell.
And you don't take her for granted. So that's what we try to do. We appreciate her. We don't take her for granted, and we try to do the best we can for her.
So she won't leave us.
Because eventually she leaves everybody. There's nobody in show business who, I mean, even Robin Williams. Robin Williams at the very end of his life, I mean, he was struggling. He was financially, he was in debt. His television show just got canceled. That doesn't erase all the brilliance of his career.
It's still had like four
whether show business or sports or whatever, everybody has their time where it ends. So until our time ends, we're just going to ride it and keep eating cake. With our faces on it.